Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SHI graph from the 17th to the 26th that I discussed in the previous update, we see some minimal clustering seismic response to the geometry that I explained. On the 18th, 19th, remember, we see some seismic response, minimal clustering, peaking 5.7 at the Cameric Islands region. And then we had this convergence, near convergence of critical planetary geometry on the 20th and 21st. And we see minimal clustering peaking magnitude 6 at San Luis, deep below Argentina. And then we had two lunar conjunctions, one with Uranus on the 22nd and then with Jupiter on the 23rd. And again, we see minimal clustering peaking magnitude 6 at Sulawesi, Indonesia. So it wasn't all that much, but obvious seismic response nonetheless. And here it gets interesting. If you look at the next SHI graph from the 19th to the 28th, we see this colorful peak on the 25th that I briefly discussed in the previous update. And we see a high red peak. That's because Mercury is involved in two planetary conjunctions. And that will converge with Sun, Venus, Saturn in a right angle. And also Sun, Mercury, Venus in a right angle. So Venus is involved in two right angle geometries and also the Sun. And we have, on top of that, two geometries of the Moon. That's Earth, Moon, Mars in a conjunction, and also Earth, Moon, Uranus, a semi-right angle geometry. And all this geometry here converges within about 4 hours, so that's really, really tight. Now, it makes it a bit complicated here because we have this lunar conjunction with Jupiter on the 23rd, and that overlaps a bit with this peak on the 25th, because if you count about 2.5 days from Jupiter, the Jupiter conjunction on the 23rd, we end up later today, tomorrow, and there could be a higher 6 to 7 magnitude earthquake as a result. But we have this high peak here on the 25th, and this is really tight convergence, and I suspect we could see an obvious seismic response to that geometry on the 26th, 27th. Around the 27th, it's about 2.5 days from that geometry. So we have a bit of an overlap, and it makes it a bit more difficult to make estimates here. But again, I do suspect an obvious seismic response to this geometry, and that includes the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. In the solar system, we see this geometry on the 25th, actually, as we speak. Again, a very tight convergence. It starts with Mercury, Earth, Neptune in a conjunction. That's at 10:52 UTC. And that's followed by a right angle geometry, Sun, Venus, Saturn. And then we have the lunar geometry. That's Earth, Moon, Mars, the conjunction. And then Earth, Moon, Uranus in a semi-right angle geometry. And that actually happens practically at the same time. And then we have the second planetary conjunction, that is Mercury, Sun, Saturn at 13:54 UTC. And then finally, Sun, Mercury, Venus in the right angle, and that's at 15:09. So as you can see, there is only about 4 hours, and in that time, all this planetary and lunar geometry is going to happen. So again, I do expect a seismic response to this geometry, and that could peak around the 27th if you count about 2 days from the moment of this geometry. If you look at atmospheric fluctuations, we didn't have all that much. It was relatively quiet in the atmosphere in the last couple of days, somewhat like the seismic activity that we had. It was also quite minimal, but we do have these fluctuations on the 19th, and that was South Australia and up north. That's north of Sumatra near the Andaman Islands, and also further north, the western part of the Himalayan Mountains, Hindu Kush region. And its antipode is basically over the eastern Pacific, especially Central America, the Caribbean Plate, and to the south near the Nazca Plate. And then on the 23rd, we also had fluctuations again. It wasn't all that much. And we see fluctuations over the eastern part of Africa, south of Madagascar. And we did have some seismic activity there. It was in the higher 4 magnitude range, near Madagascar, actually. And then to the north, again, this is the eastern part of the Mediterranean, Greece, and also the Balkan. And Macedonia had a seismic event. It wasn't much, but it was widely felt, and that could be precursor activity, actually. And its antipode, quite simple, over the Pacific, is actually near Los Angeles. And I discussed Los Angeles in the previous update because we've seen some seismic increase there since July, and it may not take long for a larger seismic seismic event to occur in that region, Central South California. Keep that in mind. So again, we have this tight convergence of planetary lunar geometry today. Check out the website and the latest updates in our social media channels. Stay safe. Until next time.